I can start off the day today, I wanted to first remind all my brides and grooms to be, guess what? Yeah! Under one roof, you can have access to all the service providers. You could actually plan your wedding day in one sitting. Oh, Jesus. I'm talking about the bride and groom. For all of you who know what time it is, yes, bride and groom is back. The expo is going to be so on. Come through. Make a booking if you are one of them service providers. Make a booking. Get you a stall. If you are a bride or a groom, please do come through. But most importantly, if you are idol, like half of the men I work with, there's that last part of the bride and groomu okamani faruk bakaitalate Kalonzo Ray runway, that is what takes the most of them. But yes, it's so on. I will be giving you more details about it. Other than that, so get to them weddings. My name is Tinafia Swan and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Instagram was lit the night before yesterday. I didn't do the story because we were trying to find, well, this is what happened. Zari managed to actually delete pretty much all her snapbacks and clapbacks that came after the whole Diamond saga. Now, for all of you who have not yet phoned out, but I know, of course, you've phoned out, this is what happened. Diamond Platnumz was at a radio station. He was getting an interview, and then the topic headed into his past relationship with Zari. And when he started to open up, he kind of rather opened up a lot. He goes and claims that, ooh, when he had just met, when they were just dating before they had Tifa, Zari slept with P Square's half, Peter Okoye. Then he claimed that Zari was also sleeping with her fitness and her in-house fitness instructor. I done seen his images and I'm like, you go girl, I would also do something with that. If I. Anywho, because you're single. So after he made all those claims, Zari was like, oh no, you didn't. I will not be taking this. I will not take it lying down. I will so not take it. She goes on Instagram and she starts to rain. It was a reign of terror of sorts. She was snapping back and clapping back at everybody. She tells us Diamond has actually not seen his kids since October. That's one. Two, he's not even paying child support because the law is trying to sort that out. Both their lawyers. Then she tells him to grow up and grow some balls and look after his own. And then all these infidelity things, well, she kind of brushed them aside. She didn't really delve into them, but all she says is she did not. People, all I can say is the tea was extremely hot. I got me popcorn and I was hoping I could do, oh God, my software needs to be upgraded. Anyway, so at the moment, they've had that back and forth, but that back and forth was everything for me because finally, I got to see where everybody's emotions is at. Number one, Diamond Platnumz, you claim you are so, so happy with Tinashe, right? Why do you even bother letting people, why would you let an interview go into a direction that you don't want? I mean, that's the beautiful thing about being a celebrity. When they call you for an interview, you can tell them, yeah, we're finna do the interview, but there's this and this, I don't want to talk about them. But clearly you're inviting it. Number two, Zari, you claim to be so happy with Mr. M or Mr. X, whichever letter of the alphabet you have. You claim to be happy. You claim he's loving your kids, all five of them, like as though they're his own. You claim money ain't a thing. So, with all those claims, why the fuck do you give two bits about what Diamond Platnumz has to say about you? Truth of the matter is, you're not together anymore. Why would you care? You just keep it moving, keep it stepping and moving to your beautiful life. Let him die with his own demons, but no, you could not. You could not. And do you know why you cannot? Because it's not even about the attention. It's not about the fact that he's attacking your person. It's simply the fact that y'all is still hung upon each other. You coexist for each other and you don't even know it. Okay, now I think you know it. To be honest, I think you know it. Because all of you are pretending to be perfectly fine. So Tinashe, poor woman, stupidly also jumped into the conversation with her weird boobs. Oh, sorry, did I say that? Y'all always make fun of my boobs and how I don't wear bras. God damn, Tinashe's boobs are not life at all. Anyway, she was dragged into it too. The thing though here, I'm like, anyway, what do I have to say? First of all, project, what happened to the project? Y'all remember when you had just met up, you told us it was a project. When you just met up, you were telling us all these, oh, y'all don't even like us. I understand. Love does grow bitter. Love does get sour. I do understand you can fall out of love with somebody and look at them as your next perfect enemy. But the two of you are actually being idiots. You're being dimwits. And I keep saying this about this girl. Y'all like her to motivate you, but she needs some motivation of her own. If you's a grown ass bitch the way you are, Zari, you are 38. Plus 3, because that's the way we count ages in Uganda. By now you should know better. You've slept with way too many young boys. You know how they act up. You know that they are emotional. They are emotional beings. They're sissies. And that's what Diamond Platnumz is. For you to ask him to grow some balls, I'm wondering. You posted a couple of days ago and you're like, I love to leave my men better than when I phone them, I build them, I grow them. Well, you didn't grow this idiot up, did you? You didn't grow him up enough to even understand that as a father, you can put your ish on the side and come through for your kids. So that's you contradicting your own words. It's you contradicting yourself. How do you even sleep at night, Butang? How? Now, this is not me even passing judgment, but at the end of the day, we've all had a bad baby daddy somewhere who is a dimwit, who is a dead-ass father. We have. We honestly have. But it's how you choose to react to their claims and allegations that sets you apart. You call yourself a boss. Honey, this was not a boss move. A boss move is the type who will see you run your mouth, go say ish, and she'll just be like, no comment. Hey, boo, pass me that love. That's what a boss would do. Because you know, for a fact, it's not just her suffering. Even men who sleep with young girls will tell you they're emotional beings. They're all over the place. And then you choose them for a baby father, not just for one child, two kids. You should have seen this coming. And I have a perfect sense of believing that at a certain point, it's going to go out of, I don't know how to even explain it, but this is a bad look. But I'm not going to sit here and be like, oh my goodness, Molina Havana, put your ish on the side. No, baby. I am a social media in-law. I am entitled to this relationship or this breakup. So I will speak on it. But in my honest opinion, you do not let someone drag you down with them. That is what strong women do. If he's trying to drag you down, pay him no attention. Silence speaks volumes. You were supposed to keep it, huh? You were supposed to pull that classic Muganda thing where they used to tell us, basenga wagambo, msaje bakuma wakanga ayomba. Nga you feel you cannot control yourself. You are amazi mukamokole, but toga mina mpaka against. You get what I'm saying? That's what you were supposed to do. But I got to put them with love issues. So I want to understand the new norm and trend in Uganda with artists or performers and entertainers throwing punches. So I'm trying to confirm a story that Salvador Bitapu, did he beat up a fan? What, did he make a bad joke? I mean, like, who goes to watch comedy and you get so offended you finna have a fist fight? Is it that deep? Is it always that deep? I mean, you know you went to have laughs. You know you're going to meet satire. You're going to meet funny jokes. That's why you went. You went to get your haha moment and you came back with what? Obumondemu face. Chai. Anyway, if it's true, man, that's some look, Salvador. That's some look. Maybe if they were attacking your person and you were defending yourself. Another person I had who fought. In my language, my grandmother would say, I don't know if any of you will understand it, they should be like, Odebegere irenke nsaho yomunyu. Or, Odebegere irenke kidiere hamaiz. I don't know. That's how, whenever I see her, that analogy goes through. You know how a fairy sits on flat on the water and it just goes like, eh. Whenever I see full figure, that's what I feel. That's what I think. Anyway, apparently, so she's at this, she's at a performance, innit? She had to perform. So the lineup had Jose Chameleon, John Black, and then her. That is how they were supposed to appear on stage. So Jose goes on stage, does his thing. Then she come up and she's like, I cannot go on after John Black because simply, he's an upcoming artist. Atenza, I am known. Banange, enyimba za full figure mumanyi mmeka. Huh? I don't even know it, because it has her in Palazzo. How would I listen to that? I can't. Anyway, that was her claim. DJ was like, yo, wait. We are supposed to do our thing. You're paid to just come on stage. And that's how we lined it up. She lost her ish when she had, as she was having the conversation, they played John Black's music for him to come on stage. She go like, not today. I said, hear me out. Panchezi DJ Fiki. Yes, she started the fight, but ani yakubie. Because that would be interesting. That would be interesting for me to watch. Anyway, she got into an altercation. Was that an altercation or a full-blown fight? Then Gravity Omutujupua man, he was at a concert. Those things, watch him wesiva kubi intubi yaba America. This is Africa, TIA. Bine bintubi okwe throwing in the crowd. You should ask Sean Paul what happened to him in Nairobi. We take off your shoes, your jewelry, anything on your person. We could actually take your clothes. Sombu, he fell in the people's. Then the people's were trying to move him and he felt someone taking out his phone. Which dummy does that? How do you fall in a crowd full of people holding your iPhone and you think that they won't take it? Have you met the crowd of people you sing for, Butain? Have you? So anyway, he felt someone trying to take out his phone. He went into straight Mutuju mode. Yeah, it was like I was watching a Rocky movie. Boop, 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 boop. Oh, this industry, though. It's Thursday, right? I don't even have, I'm going to throw back to the years when we just had Peter Sematsimber, Prim and Proper, Steve Jean, and who else? I'm throwing back to that generation. Everything was calm. The industry had professionals. It was understood that it was not just an industry for the love of music. No, they understood it was a business. And that's why you see most of them that I have talked about build empires. You want fame. You want money. These guys did it the right way. Can't keep wasting all my advice on this here industry. Maybe I should become an artist. But anyway, that's been my time. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and at TinaFierce1. Not forgetting on Instagram, yes, it's TinaFierce1 with an H. I'll catch you again tomorrow when it's going to be a Friday. I'm out. Peace.